should take like light colors mussar and not so much colors. We can use white mussars also. We should use Omani styles in naqsh of mussar. We say in Omani, naqsh. That's all about mussar.
Tell us more about naqsh. Can you show it to us?
Maybe I can show it by
this is naqsh.
Yes, this is our naqsh and other naqshes. There shouldn't be too many naqshes in mussar.
And like this also, this not is good.
Okay.
In Oman, like four quarters in the naqsh, and it could be in any color, but it shouldn't be too dark. It should be light to be good for rain.
Okay. So let's go see what is going to be your choice. Okay.
Okay.
The expert is here to help you.
Now this is what we call pashmina.
Okay.
This is the top range.
Top range.
Yep.
So what's the difference in this? It must be the material itself.
Yeah, it is. It's the material which you're looking at. Okay. The tradition goes with mussar. It's a long way. It's history.
Okay.
The tradition you have to follow.
Okay.
For Oman, you have to follow a tradition.
Okay.
And mussar is the traditional thing, as you know about the Thai.
Yeah.
You have to have it.
Yes.
And this is one thing which you have to have.
Okay.
The headgear.
So I see this year there's a lot of stripes and checks.
Yeah, it depends. It varies from person to person.
Yeah.
What kind of choice do you have?
Yeah.
Things like that.
Okay.
And it depends on what quality you're looking at.
Yes.
So it's basically if you want to pay something nice and you know soft,
yes,
you have it. This is the fashion.
So now we have decided on something. So this be your choice. Do you like it?
Yeah, I like it.
Father approves?
Not yet.
Not yet?
I'm looking for him like a light blue.
Uh-huh.
This is white. Uh-huh. That would be matching more.
Oh, you like it? Father says blue.
I like this one.
But I'm showing one the other one. Okay.
One another one, okay. This is the choice of Junaid's father. Are we happy, Junaid? What are we going to do?
I don't know.
We will make sure the father wears that in the blue and you get to wear it. Yeah. Yes. Good. What do you think, Junaid?
I don't like his color.
He wears it, right? We'll make him wear it.
Yes. If he likes it.
Yeah.
So this is how we are going to choose colors. What's your name, sir?
My name is Salim.
Salim, show us how you think.
So you will do it. So you'll do it like this.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
It's easier.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then you will see how it looks like.
Alright. So do you go with this color?
Maybe. I'm still looking for others.
Okay.
How many you willing to spend in there?
It depends.
I mean still what's your preference?
Hundred riyals, it depends. If it is only for occasions, then it might be for 100 or even more. But if it is for daily use, then it will be less.
40, 35. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We've learned so much about mussar and how important it is to Eid al-Fitr, and most importantly, it's a personal statement, whether it is the texture or the color itself. There are trends for youth and the older. But of course, along with it all, is extremely important is this, the Omani kumma. They're handmade. They come in different colors and different sizes.
Hassan Al-Wahebi has chosen his. It's going to be a purple lavender. Oh, beautiful. So this is for the first day of Eid al-Fitr.
Yeah. I bought only one and I'm making lines, so it will be
for the dishwasher.
Yeah, for the dishwasher. Yeah.
Okay, so you need to find your color first.
Yeah, I brought my kumma with me, so
oh,
that will match
also
with the color.
Okay.
Yeah.
This kumma has to match with the mussar?
No, but the new fashion.
Oh, this is a new trend.
Yeah. Oh,
sure.